Rose going out there to Procter & Gamble's Labs English Rose. So if that's you, Christine, that one's for you, love. Go on it, mate.
Yeah, that's for Chris. And the next one, Simon, is A Bomb in Wardour Street.
Right, Wardour Street. Tell me about that.
Wardour Street is actually off Leicester Square. Now, Wardour Street was famous primarily for one thing. From the 60s, it was the venue. There was a club there called the Marquee. The Marquee was a world-famous music venue. Yes. I think the Rolling Stones played their first ever gig there in 1962. Pink Floyd played there from 66 to 67. They played loads of times. But you had groups like T-Rex, Status Quo, The Stranglers.
Pistols.
Yeah, you know, there's loads. The Jam as well.
It's like iconic, isn't it? You can see the posters and you're still getting for sale on eBay and all that, like the Jam at the Marquee. And
Well, Rod Stewart played there, Elton John. It was a very, very popular venue. It wasn't a big venue.
Very similar to the Hacienda in the 90s,
I suppose. It's not there in its original form. I think there's still a club there called the Marquee, but it's not the original one. This song, again, I think it is punky, Simon. You said before. It's quite punky, this one. Yeah. You know, it just shows you that the Jam did have punk influences.
Yeah.
And when they first started, they weren't actually part of the punk set, because that was the Pistols and the Clash, you know. But I think the Clash had seen them and heard them, and the Clash basically, I think they toured supporting the Clash.
Yeah.
Because I think Joe Strummer and Mick Jones said, you know, these guys are pretty good.
Well, as you can tell with the Clash, as the Clash went on, they sort of like changed their ways, didn't they?
Yeah.
They sort of like come round, you know, to this sort of music, didn't they?
Well, like you said before, Sam, we'll have to do a Clash album. Yeah. It's either Sandinista Rocks or London Calling. London Calling. Yeah. I'd probably do London Calling because it's, Rolling Stone rate is one of the best albums of all time. If it's in the top 10 albums of all time, call it Rolling Stone.
So it can't be that bad then, can it?
Yeah.
It can't be that bad, Strummer, can it?
Strummer was a genius.
Oh, no, yeah.
But this is A Bomb in Wardour Street.
Calling the army, they're calling a Palestine.
bottom in Waldorf Street.
And the next one is... I'm going to cheat here, Simon.
Why is that, Paul?
Well, the next song isn't actually on All Mod Cons.
Yeah.
It's a song called The Butterfly Collector. Now, I've got round this because I go in a pub called The Red Lion.
Right.
And there's two guys in there called Tony and Dave Gorton.
Right.
Right. And Tony's a massive Weller fan.
Yeah.
And Tony told me that about The Butterfly Collector. And he said it was actually on the American album.
Yeah.
So when this album was released in America, they put this, The Butterfly Collector. So that's how I've got round this, you see.
Ah, well,
you know, I've done it for a reason, Simon, because to me, this is the best song Paul Weller's ever done. It's just stunning. The material's very dark, what he's singing about, but it's an absolute belting song. And I was talking to a guy in work today called Tony Shepherd, who's, I think I've mentioned.
Well,
Shep told me, like, you know, he's met Bruce Foxton on a few occasions, and he says Tony's a great bass player. And he says, like, you know, he's been a big influence on his life.
Yeah.
I'd like to dedicate this one to Shep and to another lad. They're in the same band, actually, called Feel Good Inc.
Right.
And
they play this sort of music as well.
They're a request band now, but they used to, you know, but they are very, very good. And I'd like to also mention Steve Clancy, the drummer.
Right.
I have mentioned Steve in the past.
Yeah.
But this one goes out to Steve and to Shep, and this is The Butterfly Collector. Enjoy.
So you finally got what you wanted. You've achieved your aim by making the walking lame. And when you just can't get any higher, you use your senses to suss out this week's climber. And the small fame that you've acquired brought you into cult status, but to me you're still a collector. It's darts and holes, but you're much more. You're a different kind, cause you want their minds, and you just don't care, cause you've got no pride. It's just that face on the bill of case that fills you. Started looking much older, and your fashion sense is second rate, like your perfume. But to you, in your own little dream world, you're still the queen of the butterfly collectors. As you carry on, that is all you know. You're light and fine. So you get from day to day, I'm filling your head, but you surely must know you feel between your legs as you know. And I don't care about morals, cause the world's insane and we're all to blame anyway. And I don't feel any sorrow towards the kings and queens of the butterfly collectors. There's tops and hoes, but you're much more. You're a different kind, cause you want their minds, and you just don't care, cause you've got no pride. It's just that face and the pillow face that thrills you. Carry on, cause it's all you know. You can't light a fire, you can't cook a soul. You get from day to day, I'm filling your head. But you surely must know you're built between your legs as worn off. And I don't feel any sorrow towards the kings and queens of the butterfly collectors.
That was a butterfly collector going out to your mates, wasn't it, mate?
Yeah, that's for Shep and Steve. And so that should be the end of the show, Si.
It should be, yeah, but we're cheated, haven't we?
Yeah, a little bit. We decided we're going to play one more jam song that's not on All Mod Cons. I think it was released 2 years later.
Yeah, we were talking off air, and we just had to throw this in.
Yeah, you do,
we?
Because it's... I think it's one of... This got to number 21 in the charts on import sales alone. That's all it was. It was never released as a single over
here. Was it not?
So it was just on import sales.
And you still hear this today, and you can hear it on an acoustic version, and it sounds absolutely amazing.
Well, I'm pretty sure that Rolling Stone did a poll of the 500 greatest songs of all time, and this is the only song that Paul Weller, which is an absolute travesty in my eyes, it's actually in the Rolling Stones 500 greatest songs of all time, because the Jam were massive in the UK, but they never really cracked America. I can never understand that.
Very similar to Squeeze as well.
Yeah,
they was very similar, weren't they?
Yeah,
they was massive over here. And when he first went to America, they called them to the new Lennon and McCartney. Didn't
they? Oh, different Tilbrook. But this song, and I always remember when I first heard this on Peely's show in 1981, and it's just, well, I think he wrote this in 15 minutes. He'd had a few drinks, and he just took him 15 minutes to write this. Just shows how good...
Brilliant he is.
And it's just basically, it's called That's Entertainment. And next week, we're on for an hour again, aren't we, Si?
Yeah, we'll do an hour next week.
We're doing another year show.
What's the year, mate?
Well, Glenn from work has asked me to play 1982.
Right.
So we'll do about 12 songs from 1982.
Yeah, so if anyone wants to pick any
from 82, we'll gladly play it for you.
Get in touch with Noddy on the Facebook page and the Sounds of Soul Food.
And we'll have a chat about the song, you know, and we'll play all the songs that are requested.
Yeah.
But I've got a few good ones, you know, from 82, which, you know, I'm pretty sure most people are like.
Yeah.
And this, Glenn, so next week, it's for you, mate. Thanks. And thanks very much for tonight, Simon.
No, thank you. Yeah, I love the Jam, Noddy. Anyway, it's a great choice, this, I'm telling you, mate. I really do love the Jam.
Nice one. So,
cheers, mate.
This is That's Entertainment.